Welcome to another tutorial. So, here I have an untextured model. It's already UV unwrapped and ready for painting. Okay, let's go to object mode. Select your mesh. Check the shadeless option for the material. Now reflections and shadows won't get in the way. Go to the texture paint mode. It's purple because we don't have an image texture yet. Go to the slots tab. You will notice that this material doesn't have a paint slot. In the tools tab, add a paint slot. We'll make it a diffuse color paint slot. I like to use a 256 by 256 pixels texture for quick paintings. Now we have a black texture. Let's create a new brush. I like to use a 36 pixel radius with 0.6 strength configuration for my brush. Now, you can paint directly on the mesh. Press X to change to your secondary color. I will quickly make a rough texture so I can show the solution to a problem. Okay, now I have to show you some problematic stuff. Go to the material mode. Uncheck shadeless. Now make the texture influence specularity and bump maps. Uncheck specular intensity if it's too bright. You will notice some black lines in the places where the UV seams are located. If you zoom out, you can see them clearly. I will show you a way to solve this problem. Go to edit mode. With all the faces selected, go to the UV image editor. Create a new image. Give it a name. The size will be 1024 by 1024. Now we have a black texture. Go to the bake options and set the bake mode to textures. Hit the bake button. Not only is TIS texture higher resolution, but it also has a padding of 16 pixels. Now, let's replace the old texture. Go to the texture tab. In the image options, select the new texture. Now if you zoom out you will notice the lines are almost gone. Go back to texture paint mode. You can retouch the texture at this higher resolution to get rid of the rest of the imperfections. But I will show you some more interesting stuff. I use Smart UV Project to UV unwrap this mesh. If you place the seams manually, you will get much better results. Do not forget to save your texture, or it might disappear. As you can see, hand-painted textures can add a lot of detail to low-poly models. I have made a green version of the same texture. The grayscale texture is used to generate the bump maps. The green texture adds the diffuse and specular color information. That was the untextured model. See how much difference a simple texture can make? You can use even more layers, adding clothing textures, faces and other details. Anyway, if the tutorial helped you somehow, drop a like. tutorials every day. Check my other tutorials and subscribe for more.